that was easy. We were using Iamprites, wherever it's gone, and a piece of flint. What do you do when you don't have these? So we go backwards further in time, and we go back to rubbing pieces of wood together to create our ember and going through that whole process once again. So I've prepared this, and again, it's learning about the properties of wood, what works, what doesn't. Hardwoods don't work, and what I have here is ivy and willow. These are medium grade woods. Ivy produces a lot of fibres, and the willow does also, but because it's roughly the same density, the two work really well together. So I need my hearth, I need my drill, I then need something to catch my ember on. So this is my ember pan. That goes on the bottom, my hearth goes on top, and then my bow. So the principle is the drill sits in and rotates back and forth. And this is where experience comes in, knowing how much pressure to put in and the speed that you're bowing, and combining them together to first build up your fibres here, and then speeding up and creating that heat that's generated to get this going. And we're looking to reach a temperature of about 600 degrees Celsius for that to go. And let's see how it goes. Now, if I was just to drill like this and put my hand on, I'm going to put a hole in my hand, so I need something on top. And what I'm using today are just some shells, or I could just use a piece of hardwood, which will go at the pointed end of the drill, minimizing our friction and maximizing it on the other end. But personally, I like shells because they fit my hand beautifully. So let's go for this. I'm starting gently, warming the wood up. As you can see, we're getting basic smoke coming. So I keep at this, keeping the pressure just right, and I can see that the notch I've cut, I'm beginning to get fibres. So those fibres are going, and now I'm going to speed up and increase the downward pressure until my arm falls off. And now I can take a bit of a breather. So I'm going to use a piece of stick and very gently remove that ember. And this is what we are looking for. A nice glowing ember that will probably burn probably about 2 minutes. That's going nicely. As you can see, we've got a good plume of smoke. As that begins to coalesce, which is all the fibres coming together with the heat, we will start seeing a glowing coal. When we get to that stage, then we will transfer that into our prepared tinder bundle. And being very gentle, I get that in. Any fibres left, get them in as well. And then we go through that whole process. There we go. So that's going to go there. So my next set of materials, I've been lucky enough, I was able to find dry grass. That goes on, and then I start putting all my really thin pieces of wood on first, and then we just carry on. We've had a look at how to light fires, and what we've seen is that modern day man uses lighters quite easily, and it makes life very, very easy for us. We also had a look at flint and steel, and remember, steel is very easy to come by in this modern day and age. Prehistoric man wouldn't have had the ability to get hold of steel readily. Well, how we created fire was using Iamprites. And as I said, Iamprites is found in roughly the same location that flint is. So the two marry up nicely and we were able to create fire from there. And then the hardest method, we used a bow drill method, which is fire by friction, where we created our coal in this notch and then went through the whole process of using that coal with the tinders and getting our fire that we were able to cook with. I'd just like to say that all of these techniques can be dangerous, and you should not do these at home. If you want to learn more, go along to a reputable bushcraft company or a survival school, where they will be able to teach you all the knowledge that you need how to light fires safely, being considerate about the environment and leaving a minimal impact out in the woods so that we can come back and enjoy it again and again.